Hey, fellas, welcome back to another episode of Fallout 4. Date of recording is still January 22nd. I don't know how much more I'm gonna do, but we're gonna here talk to Preston here. Which I think I talked to him about other things too.
Hey, what do you need, General?
Signal interceptor.
I have plans here to build a signal interceptor that can get me inside the Institute.
The Institute? Why in the world would you want to mess around with them?
Well, they got my son.
They kidnapped my son.
Damn. That's some bad business. Even for them.
We'll give you whatever help we can. Don't worry about that. Now, assuming you could build this thing, what exactly does it do?
Transports me there.
The Institute uses teleportation to get in and out. This machine can hijack their signal and send me instead.
Teleportation? For real? Wow. That would explain a lot about how the Institute manages to operate. If anyone can make heads or tails of those plans, it'd be Sturgis. I haven't found anything yet that he couldn't build or fix. I'll let you know if I have any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it.
Yeah, I know.
We only help our cause.
I know. But...
Hey.
Is there something you need?
How about you come with us?
Come with me. I need your help.
Sure thing, General. I think the folks here can manage on their own now, thanks to you.
Yeah.
Don't worry, Dogmeat. I'll take good care of him.
Oh no, he's coming with us. Alright, Sturgis, where are you? That way I have an extra pair of hands to carry more stuff for me.
What's up?
Preston thought you might be able to figure out these plans for me.
Sure thing. Let's see what you've got.
Here you go.
Here you go.
Wow. What a mess. Looks like, encrypted RF transmissions. Okay, so that gets routed through... What the hell? Teleportation. This is some pretty crazy shit. You sure it's for real?
Absolutely.
It's real. I got it from an ex-Institute scientist.
Seriously? I didn't know you could be an ex-Institute anything and still be breathing. Anyway,
that's true.
The eggheads never think about the nuts and bolts of actually making something work. But, looks like it's all here. Yeah, I'm gonna need some time to study this thing. The handwriting's pretty hard to make out.
Okay.
But, you can get started on what he calls a stabilized reflector platform.
Okay.
It'll need some pretty high-grade metals. But it's basically not that different than the lining of a jet engine or something like that.
Okay, good.
Good work, Sturgis.
Well, don't thank me yet. I think I got the gist of it. But it's gonna take some time to work out the details of some of the hairier sections.
Okay.
Here's a list of what you'll need for the first piece. I'm pretty sure we've got all that at Sanctuary, if you want to build it there.
While yeah,
working
I'll
on
it
that,
here.
I'll get busy figuring out how to actually build the rest of this thing. Keep in mind, I can already see this is gonna take a crazy amount of juice. Like if you had a spare nuclear reactor handy, we could probably use it. And it's going to be big. So find a nice open building site with lots of power available.
Lots of power available. Move, guys. Well, right here. Right here. Right on this platform right here. It seems perfect. So special. Artillery. Yeah. Oh, look, we got stuff. Look at that. We got this stuff. Build it. I got it. Talk to Sturgis.
I've worn out a lot of shoe leather since I joined the Minutemen.
How's it going? Did you find a good spot to build your signal interceptor?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Ready to build the rest of it.
Good. I think I got a handle on this crazy contraption. At least as much as I can tell. Until we actually try to build it,
there's
a list of three things that may be harder to find. I think I'll be able to pull together everything else we're gonna need. I'll meet you over at the building site and see if we can actually make this thing work.
Well, it's right here, so...
Thanks, Sturgis. I'll get right on this.
Good deal. One thing to keep in mind while you're building this, it all needs to be wired together so all the pieces can talk to each other. I'll see you over at the building site. Good luck.
It's right behind you, dude. Alright, special. Console control. We'll put like right over here. Right there. And we got beam emitter. Oh, that looks like it goes right there. Yeah. Can we rotate it? No? Don't look like it. Okay. Yeah, we're gonna need lots of power, man. Oh, shit. We'll go, like, kind of in the direction of the Institute, maybe? Like, around there, probably? Yeah, we already got that. Okay. Power it up! So we need, oh my god, 5. I don't know how much that requires. 21. It's 26 so far. Big generators. Big generators. When that only does 3. We got plenty of stuff to build generators, so. Where should we stick it stuff? Maybe like right over here. 10. Twenty. 5. Maybe we should just go with 30 just to be safe. Attach wire to that one. Attach wire to that one. Okay. Attach wire to that. Attach wire to that. Attach wire to that. Okay, so that one's already. Okay. Cool! Alright! Oh, baby! Oh, baby, baby, baby! Oh, yeah!
Everything looks good on my end. You ready to see if this thing actually works?
Hell yeah, let's do it!
Let's do this.
You sure? Okay. Your part is simple. Just step onto the platform.
Okay.
I'll start scanning for an Institute signal to lock onto. Then, I fire her up and we see what happens.
All right, I got you. Oh boy.
Whenever you're ready.
I'm ready. Let's do this. I can't move, so we're doing something right.
Okay, hold real still.
Okay.
I don't want any corruption of the molecular beam. Oh yeah, by the way, I figured this was a golden opportunity to find out as much as we can about the Institute and what they're up to. Yeah, this holotape's all set with a program that will scan their network and download anything it finds.
All right. Oh, shit.
Uh-oh. Yeah, we better hurry.
Hurry up!
Hurry about that tubing wiggling around. It's just there for decoration.
Oh, yeah, scanning. Sure.
Scanning for the Institute signal. Tracking RF. And
see you guys.
Got it. Hold on to your butt.
Ah! Woo! Whoa! Shit! Oh, and level up. What a perfect opportunity. There's a relay. Woohoo! I'm gonna level up now. What do I want? I can still do pistols. Can't do that one yet. That didn't really help at all. I need that one though too. I'm not worried about it. Until I want it, and then I'm like, oh, I should have got it. Do 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 do. I'm not worried about science. Thank you. radiation weapons. Oh. Well, we can't do that until we actually upgrade more of our permanent ones. No, I don't care about melee. How about more money? We need to find more money. I'm going with that. Yes. Alright. Yeah, I can do that. Load holotape. Join the railroad? Network scanner, I believe that's what it is. Hang on. Let's make sure. Yeah, network scanner. I'll do it. Load. Network scanner. Initiate. Yeah, there we go. Alright. Got that. Any goodies I can find? Whoops. Wrong spot. Give to Sturges. Okay. Can't really do anything yet. Ooh, hello.
Hello.
Oh, hi.
I wondered if you might make it here. You're quite resourceful. I'm known as Father. The Institute is under my guidance. I know why you're here.
You do?
I'd like to discuss things with you face to face. Please, step into the elevator.
Just give me one moment. I want to find some goodies. Ooh. Okay. They seem friendly so far. Whoa, dude. Why do I need lead.
It's stuck.
It's stuck. Ooh, a lab coat. Alright, I'm entering. Button. Whoa. Ooh. Ooh. Whoa.
I can only imagine what you've heard. What you think of us. I'd like to show you that you may have the wrong impression.
Oh yeah? Is this thing rotating?
To the Institute. This
Whoa.
Is the reality of the Institute. This place, these people, the work we do.
Ooh.
For over 100 years, we've dedicated ourselves to humanity's survival. Decades of research, countless experiments and trials, a shared vision of how science can help shape the future. It has never been easy. And our actions are often misinterpreted by those above ground. Someday, perhaps, we can show them what we've accomplished. But for now, we must remain underground.
Okay.
There's too much at stake here to risk it all. As you've seen, things above are unstable. I'd like to talk to you about what we can do for everyone. But that can wait. You are here for a specific, very personal reason. You are here for your son.
Uh-huh. Sean!
Sean?
Huh? Yes, I'm Sean.
Sean? Oh my god. It's really you.
Who are you?
Sean.
Father!
It's me.
What's happening?
I'm your dad. Sean, are you okay? You're not hurt, are you?
What's going on? Father? Father!
Shh. It'll be okay, Sean. I'm here now.
I don't know you. Go away! Father! Father, help me! There's someone here! Help me!
Please,
father?
Sean! I'm your father!
Father, help me!
Talk to me!
He's trying to take
Just
me.
Open the door!
Father, help me!
Sean.
S923, recall code Cirrus.
What the hell?
Fascinating, but disappointing. The child's responses were not at all what I anticipated. He's a prototype, you understand.
Hey, since Piper is here.
We're only just now beginning to explore the effects of extreme emotional stimuli. Please try and keep an open mind. I recognize that you are emotional, and that your journey here has been fraught with challenges. Let's start anew. I am Father. Welcome to the Institute.
Give me Sean! The real Sean! Right now!
I know. I know. You've gone to such lengths to find him.
Okay. Well...
I want answers, asshole. Now!
Under the circumstances, I will forgive your vulgarity, but I need you to realize that this situation is far more complicated than you could have imagined. You have traveled very far, and suffered a great deal to find your son. Well, your tenacity and dedication have been rewarded. It's good to finally meet you, after all this time. It's me. I am Sean.
What?
I am. Your son.
What?
How is that even possible?
I know this is a lot to take in. In the vault, you had no concept of the passage of time. You were released from your pod and went searching for the son you'd lost. But then you learned that your son was no longer an infant. But a 10-year-old boy. You believed that 10 years had passed. Is it really so hard to accept that it was not 10, but 60 years? That is the reality. And here I am. Raised by the Institute, and now its leader.
Wow.
They stole you. Kidnapped you. Wasn't right.
Right, wrong, irrelevant. It was necessary. The Institute believed humanity's future depended on it. At that time, the year 2227, the Institute had made great strides in synth production. But it was never enough. Scientific curiosity and the goal of perfection drove them ever onward. What they wanted was the perfect machine. So they followed the best example thus far. The human being, walking, talking, fully articulate, capable of anything.
Okay.
So the weird science experiments needed specimens. That's why they took you.
In a manner of speaking, yes. The Institute endeavored to create synthetic organics. The most logical starting point, of course, was human DNA. Plenty of that was available, of course. But it had all become corrupted. In this wasteland, radiation affected everyone. Even in their attempts to shield themselves from the world above, members of the Institute had been exposed. Another source was necessary. But then the Institute found me. After discovering records from Vault 111, an infant, frozen in time, protected from the radiation-induced mutations that had crept into every other human cell in the Commonwealth. I was exactly what they needed. And so it was my DNA that became the basis of the synthetic organics used to create every human-like synth you see today. I am their father. Through science, we are family. The synths, me, and you.
Years. So much time. Wasted.
I know. I know you must have questions. Please. Anything I can do to help you understand. Yes. What happened to her was... I've gone over the records of the incident, of course. It seems her death was an unfortunate bit of collateral damage.
Oh boy, collateral damage.
Collateral damage? Is that all she was to you?
I forget that it's been such a short time for you. I don't have any direct memories. And I've had my entire life to cope with the loss. Has it always been easy? Of course not. But I've done my best to move on and live my life. For many years, I never questioned who my parents were. I accepted my situation, and that was that. With old age comes regret, and asking what if more often. But what matters now is that you and I have a chance to begin again.
Mm-hmm.
What else can I say to ease your mind?
So what about Kellogg?
Kellogg? He worked for you?
Kellogg. He was an Institute asset long before I arrived here. It wasn't until I became director that I learned of all the things he'd done. What kind of man he was.
So you used him?
You knew the man was a psychopath, but you used him anyway?
Would you have preferred that I turned him loose on the Commonwealth? At least keeping him on a short leash kept the collateral damage to a minimum. The Institute took advantage of Kellogg's vicious nature. I will freely admit that. Institute technology prolonged his life, and his usefulness far beyond any normal human lifespan. He never failed the Institute, but his cruelty became more apparent with every completed objective. I won't lie. It's no coincidence your path crossed his. It seemed a fitting way to allow you, us, to have some amount of revenge.
Hmm.
What else can I say to ease your mind?
So the Institute?
So you're in charge of the Institute?
I am the acting director, yes. I spent decades working to reach this point. It's a responsibility I take very seriously. The Institute. It's important. It really is humanity's best hope for the future, no matter what those above ground might think of us.
So then we need your help then.
They need your help, Sean. It's rough up there, to say the least.
Oh, we've tried that. Surprised? The Institute once tried to help create a stabilized Commonwealth government. It ended in bickering, infighting. It was a disaster. No. We look after our own now. Ultimately, the Commonwealth has nothing to fear from us. Whatever you've seen or heard, I know I can convince you of that. Just give me time. I know there's more for us to discuss. But... the Institute is on the verge of some important breakthroughs.
Mm-hmm.
Your presence would be appreciated as we approach them.
Okay.
I've been a part of something amazing here. I've helped to build a life for myself and the people of the Institute. And now, after all these years, you have an opportunity to help with that. Doesn't that intrigue you? Isn't that what you want?
Yes. That's what I want.
I know. I know you've been through so much. I'm pleased to see it has not impaired your judgment. Forgive me. I'd assume that after everything I'm sure you've seen above ground, you would be more than a bit biased against us. There is much to be done. You'll need time to acclimate yourself, a chance to become acquainted with our procedures.
Not taking orders.
I'll do whatever it takes. It's worth it.
I am glad to hear that. The Institute is now your home as much as it is mine. Please take some time, get to know it. Meet the people you'll be working with. You'll want to introduce yourself to the division heads. Dr. Fillmore in Facilities. Dr. Ayo in SRB. Dr. Holdren in Bioscience. And finally, Dr. Lee in Advanced Systems. They've all been notified of your arrival, of course. Meet them, and then we'll discuss what comes next.
Okay. Do you have stuff I need? Tweezers, spanner, applicator. Oh, buddy. All the stuff that I might need. Oh, this is beautiful. Ooh. Yeah. Uh-huh. Wait. Oh. Let me in here. Yeah. Uh-huh. Microphone. I thought I needed a microphone. No, microscope is what I need. Uh-huh. Look at that. Oh, we're getting all the stuff we need. Beautiful. Yeah, buddy. Oh, crap. Crap. Okay. So, junk. Wait, the globe. Of course the globe. It just has screw. That's fine. Alright. Oh, so much stuff. Broken lip. Okay. Let's go do whatever we need to do. Hi.
It's an honor to have you here, sir.
Oh, well, thank you. Oh, here's
almost
the first
done.
One.
Just need to tighten up this primary drive servo.
That's the third primary drive breakdown this month. As far as I'm concerned, the phase out on these older models can't come soon enough.
Oh, I don't know. Most of them have lasted long past their projected lifespans. If you ask me, they were built pretty well.
I can't argue with that. Even so,
what are you
I'm ready to see
what
the
are you figuring
Gen 3
with?
Roll out.
There we go. All set. Unit, you can return to duty.
You can't
Thanks
talk.
Again.
Of course.
Hey.
The Institute is my life. I hope it'll be yours too.
We're all looking
Excuse
forward
me,
to
doctor.
Working with you.
They weren't kidding. You really are here. Well, all right. I'm Allie. Allie Fillmore. You can think of me as the Institute's chief engineer. When Father told us about you, I could hardly believe it. You've been through so much, I think most people would have just given up. If you don't mind my asking, what was it that kept you going all that time?
Well, because to find Sean.
I just wanted to find my son and keep him safe.
Now that you've found him, I hope you're proud of the great man he grew up to be. Now, I'll give you a quick rundown of the facilities division, and then I'll answer any questions you might have afterward.
Okay.
As you might guess, we keep the Institute's mechanical and electrical systems running smoothly. We maintain and upgrade all of the systems that make it possible to live and work in a place like this. There's a lot of machinery behind these walls that recycles the air and water and provides power to the laboratories and quarters. The work we do might not be as exciting as some of the other departments, but it's at least as important. So, now that you're here and you've spoken to Father, does that mean you're on board?
Well, not so fast.
I'm not on board with anything.
No? And yet here you are, poking around. One might find that suspicious. If you're not planning on staying, I'd recommend keeping your hands to yourself. Wouldn't want to give the impression you're up to something. And consider having another talk with Sean. He really is anxious to have you with us. If there's anything else you'd like to know about the facilities division, I'm happy to discuss it.
Nah.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Goodbye, then.
Goodbye, then. Up here, I guess.
You know the protocol, sir. Authorized personnel only.
So Dr. Ayo thinks he can hide in his office, does he? Well, you can tell him that I intend to speak to Father about these unannounced security sweeps of yours. Ransacking my quarters in the middle of the night is totally unacceptable.
I'll pass along your message, Doctor.
See that you do.
Okay.
When the lights go down and the stars come out,
welcome to the man. Hi there, Courser.
All his troubles.
I'm going right here. At full capacity. Yep.
I'm seriously heading over to robotics to knock some heads together.
Okay, you people need to move.
They're dragging their feet on the targeting package upgrades I asked for.
Pardon me,
maybe
sir.
I should take some courses
You're here.
With me.
Glad you made it.
Please don't. There's enough friction as it is between us and pretty much all the other departments.
Oh.
You going soft on me, Alana? My methods get results, and they will this time as well. You'll see.
Oh.
Like any machine, a synth can malfunction. Just wish it didn't happen so often.
Sometimes you have to lean on the other departments a little to get what you need.
Hey, wait, I need to talk to you.
Doc.
So, here you are. Justin Ayo, acting director of the Synth Retention Bureau. I'll be up front with you. We're going to be keeping a close eye on you for the near future. Despite your relation to Father, you're a bit of an unknown quantity. I'm sure you understand. There won't be any issues, will there?
Nah, I guess not.
Oh, why? Don't you trust me?
I'll be honest. You're an outsider. The first outsider to be allowed access to the Institute in quite a long time, in fact. There's little precedent for this situation, so it's only natural to take extra precautions. It's nothing personal, I assure you.
Now, Father has asked that I provide you with a brief overview of the Synth Retention Bureau. Our primary responsibility is the recovery of escaped synths that are hiding among the human population on the surface.
I'm sure it's best for everyone if the synths remain here.
Certainly. We can't allow sophisticated Institute technology to fall into the wrong hands. The results could be disastrous.
Uh-huh.
Our main instrument is the Courser, a third-generation synth assigned to operate on the surface. Coursers hunt down and reclaim synths
that
have escaped the Institute. They are highly self-sufficient, trained in combat, infiltration, and tracking. In a word, our Coursers are relentless.
I know.
But I gather you know all this, since you've encountered one already. In fact, I'd very much like to know how you defeated it.
Well, I got lucky, I guess.
I guess I just got lucky.
That's hardly helpful. I suppose I'll have to ask robotics to perform detailed diagnostics on the entire production run. As if we don't have enough problems. Now, unless you need something else, I'll get back to work.
Nope, I'm good.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Very well.
Dr. Ayo?
Scanning unknown identity. What? Clearance confirmed.
That's right, I have clearance. Better believe I do.
No visible reaction to the K-14 compound. We'll start the next trial. The dosage will be much larger this time, and the side effects will be...
Advanced systems. Yellow.
She's been at it for over 2 hours. What is she even testing?
For her?
Nothing. At this point, she's just doing it for fun.
Oh, her.
Doctor.
Oh, hi there. Sorry if I seem distracted. I memorized 5 sets of design schematics, and now I'm doing detailed mental comparisons.
Okay.
That's amazing.
Oh, well, a lot of us do that. Anyway, I'm glad you're here. I just wanted to say how much I admire Father, and that it's an honor to meet you. I really hope you'll stay here with us.
Okay. Fusion cells?
Well, that was productive.
No. Well, if you have...
Ask me, we're only scratching the surface with the latest...
Fusion cells for days. I'll take them fusion cells, thank you. Thank you. I use them occasionally. So I need to find somewhere to put another piece of junk. I know. Oh, I can't get in there. Arr. Oh, crap. I guess I'll just drop something then. Sort by weight. Yeah. Good enough, right? Wow, that worked. We can just kind of set it right there, I guess. Okay. you!
Excuse me, doctor?
Ah, it's you. You're here then.
Uh-huh.
Yes, yes, I know who you are. We all do. While I'm sure Father is very happy that you're here, I do hope it doesn't interrupt our work.
Don't worry. I promise I won't get in your way.
Thank you. I do appreciate that.
Uh-huh.
Oh, before I forget, let me see that Pip-Boy of yours.
Why?
I've been told to install a Courser chip in it for
you.
Father's orders.
All right!
You'll be given full access with the ability to relay in and out of the Institute at will.
All right. Cool.
Thank you. I'm sure that'll come in handy.
Given that the relay is the only way to access the Institute, handy is something of an understatement.
In case the significance
is lost on you, you'll be the only one here with that kind of access. If nothing else, it should demonstrate the amount of trust Father has placed in you. Now, unless there's something else, I really do need to get back to work.
No problem. I'm good.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
All right.
Woohoo!
Rushed work is sloppy at best.
And we got our own relay. Ha! We got our own Courser relay. Bioscience!
Is it true food supplement 77 has been discontinued?
That is correct.
That was my favorite one.
Yeah, don't you hate when food goes discontinued? Like, I occasionally like Burger King, and they don't have the double stacker anymore. That was my favorite.
Do you have time to examine my latest reports on Batch 274?
Not yet. I've been reviewing Father's plans to expand our operations at Warwick. He's eager to get that going, so I've had to put everything else to one side.
I wonder how the Warwick family is doing. Young Wally must be close to 10 years old by now. It's really remarkable that any child can survive for so long up there, don't you think?
I try not to think too much about it. We have more than enough to occupy ourselves here. And those people are the last remnants of a dying past. It's best not to dwell on the subject.
They're still people, and they're suffering. We can at least admit that it's regrettable.
Yeah.
After all, how can we hope to redefine mankind if we can't even hold on to our own humanity?
Well, that's a question best left to our colleagues in the robotics division.
Yes, well... I suppose you're right.
Humanity's future is taking root right here.
Hi, Doc.
Welcome. So good to have you here.
Oh, can't
Dr. Clayton
you face
Holder,
me?
Head of the Bioscience Division. I can't wait for you to see the work we're doing. It's truly amazing.
I'm interested.
I look forward to learning more about it.
In that case, let me give you a brief overview of what we do here. As the name implies, the Bioscience Division specializes in fields of study such as botany, genetics, and medicine.
Mm-hmm.
Our most important directive is to ensure the health and well-being of everyone in the Institute. To that end, we cultivate highly specialized breeds of flora for use in food and medicine. We've even started to explore the idea of synthetic animal life. You probably saw the gorillas.
No.
They're really just a pet project at this point, but the potential is exciting nonetheless.
Seems like there's nothing you guys can't do.
With hard work and ingenuity, any challenge can be overcome. I'm sure I've taken up enough of your time as it is. But I have to ask, have you decided whether you'll join us?
I'm not sure yet.
I'm not sure. Right now, I'm just trying to keep an open mind.
It's a big decision, I know. But it's also a rare and important opportunity. No need to rush to judgment. In any case, I imagine you'll want to continue looking around. Or, if you prefer, I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have.
I don't have any questions.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Take care,
Yeah. Woo. Microscope. Gorillas!
Please resist any urge you might feel to eat the specimens.
Gorillas!
Showing promising results.
Oh, what's this? Ooh.
Hacking this is beyond me.
Okay, do I get hurt? No. Huh. I want to know the secret. Ooh, ooh. This looks old. Oh. Ooh, yeah, 50 caliber. Oh, it's blocked off. You see that? Something's going on. You don't mind if I snoop around, do ya? Recorder. Uh-huh. Gotta find a way in there. Terminal. Wait. What's this do? Nah. Gotta find a way in there. Ooh. This looks promising. Huh. Ooh, hello. Sweeper. Apparently I need a sweeper. Oh man, I just can't take any of this stuff. What's this over here? Okay, that's back in there, okay. High powered microscope. Ooh, it's locked. Uh-huh.
Got it.
Oh. What's in here? Ooh. Okay, guys. We're gonna stop it here. And I'll see you guys in the next episode when we figure out all this stuff, alright? So, peace out. Be quiet.